Welcome to the February 7th edition of The Week Ahead. Coming up, a sneak preview of the March Madness Reading Initiative with LHS and Lowell Middle School students. Access testing update, February 9th early release day info, an update on the Courtyard restaurant, staff and student shoutouts, and much more, including our student question of the week focusing on Black History Month. March Madness is not only a college basketball tournament that we all know about. It's starting to be what could turn into a great tradition here at Lowell High School that has been active in the community over the last several years. We're combining community service, peer mentoring, and literacy development between Lowell High School students and our middle school partners. Here today with us is Gio to share with us the Lowell High School version of March Madness. The motto for our March Madness in Lowell is books always win.
Thank you, Mr. Fiorato, for having me. My name is Giovanni Miquagna. I'm a current senior here at Lowell High School. I am in B House, involved in several activities, like I am the president of the National Honor Society, a part of the Student Site Council and the Student Advisory Council, co-captain of the mock trial team, and other several activities.
And very busy here on campus, and you're also taking on another initiative that we're here to talk about today, March Madness. So tell us what March Madness is in terms of Lowell High School, why it's important, and how it started, and where you see it going, and where do you want it to go?
Yeah, so March Book Madness is an online bracket-style tournament that matches books in one-on-one games, just like, you know, college basketball teams do. We're going to challenge each other one-on-one each week. Eventually, we'll find out what the very best book of 2022 will be. We have currently 16 books competing against each other this year. The brackets are ready. We start February 28th, and we'll be reading weekly until March 31st. Elementary school students throughout Lowell will vote weekly and choose the best book. And we start filming our read-alouds this week right here. And also, LHS has some excellent talent out there this year for readers. We have members of the basketball team, ROTC, wrestling team, National Honor Society, field hockey, Black Unity Club, step team, advisory council, student advisory council, students from band and show choir, members of the mock trial club, Model UN, and several women in STEM students, science and engineering club members, and students from the gymnastics and football teams. We're so ready to be reading.
And what book are you reading?
I am reading Change Sings by Andrea Gorman.
And so what do you see as the benefits of this program and why is it important?
I think developing the skills that students, and not only in Lowell High School, but students who will come in the future to Lowell High is very important. I also think engaging with our younger peers is a really good showmanship of how much we can support and help these little kids in different places and probably bring us a joy and a little bit of a smile to their faces.
Well, I want to thank you and thank all of your team members for starting this program. We're in the second year at Lowell High School, but it's a national program, and it's been happening in Lowell for a while. And we're adding to it and really making it an opportunity for our students here at the high school to build partnership and connections with our middle school students, which is super critical, as you said. So I want to thank you for all you do at Lowell High School, including being a partner in our March Book Madness.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you for being here today. And now for our staff shout out. We ask that our staff be highly visible before school and during dismissal to meet and greet students, build relationships, and uphold the core values and support our school-wide expectations here at Lowell High School. This staff shout out goes to Mr. Stephen Gervais, our department chair for World Languages and English Language. Mr. Gervais braves the elements of the New England weather and has been outside the main entrance every day welcoming students and modeling proper mask use and asking students to make sure their IDs are ready. He is also visible during lunch on Father Morissette Boulevard and after school at dismissal. Thank you, Mr. Gervais, for all your hard work and dedication to our school community. Access testing is upon us, and want to thank Ari Sullivan and all of the teachers for navigating the challenges of this important assessment. Access testing is a state requirement and part of our accountability data. More importantly, Access offers students a chance to demonstrate their learning proficiencies in English and English language. So keep up the good work. We'll continue Access testing throughout the month of February. And students in the spotlight. Two seniors that will be spotlighted today from our Students of the Week include Mia Frazier from the class of 2022. Mia is in the Student Advisory Council, and she's a project leader. She is captain of the girls' varsity swim team, the YMCA swim team coach, and an overall great student here at Lowell High School. Another senior is Lacey Parry, class of 2023, very athletic, starring in varsity girls basketball and varsity girls field hockey. Mia and Lacey, thanks for all you do at Lowell High School. If you haven't seen some of the improvements we've made on campus, student leaders from the Advisory Council have been busy doing billboard makeovers. We're looking for departments and house offices to keep the billboards updated and informative. Reach out to Mr. Thornton if you have any questions. Wednesday, February 9th is an early release day. We'll have an abbreviated schedule for students. There will be PD for staff starting at 12:15. Please review the weekly staff and family newsletter for details. Did you know that the Courtyard Cafe is back online thanks to the support and assistance of our Courtyard team of students and staff, custodians, DPW, and facilities crew? Last week, a guest chef from Johnson & Wales University, who boasts a solid and well-renowned culinary program, did a sushi demonstration for our students in the culinary arts class right in our school in the Courtyard Cafe. Check it out. And now the question of the week. Black History Month is upon us for the month of February, and at Lowell High School, we're so excited and proud of our diverse student body and are thankful and appreciative of the amazing contributions of Africans and African Americans to the founding and success of our nation. We want to hear from our students and staff about Black History Month and what it means to them. Check this out.
I'm Leonardo Neves from Lee House, and the Black Month history to me, it has a strong meaning to me personally, and it means resilience.
Hi, my name is Esha Souza. I'm from Lee House, junior year. And for me, it's really important because half of my family, it's Black, and it's really important for us this month to reflect on the past that we've been through.
My name is Giovanni Miquagna. I am in Bee House, and what Black History Month means to me is a month not just to celebrate the greatness, but the importance of the Black presence in America, and to just show and showcase how much we are capable of changing the world if we all combine together to kind of take a look at our history, but also take a look at how much wonderful things are happening in our society currently, and just learning to celebrate that. And that's what it means to me.
Well, that does it for the week ahead. Thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you next week. Have a great week, everybody.